Scottish National Trust, who maintain the pass for its beautiful picnicking, fishing and nature trekking, as well as for Auld Lang Syne. Ironically enough, it's an ex-British Army general who controls the invading tourists in their caravans and tents at this 30-acre Blair Castle caravan site, Major General Christopher Mann.
Christopher, what do you offer your very welcome invaders by way of fun and facilities?
We set out to give them a really good family holiday in the most marvellous surroundings. We've got a very good site shop, we've got a laundrette, our lavatories are extremely well equipped. We've got a fine children's playground, a large recreation area in the middle where the families can either picnic or play or do what they like.
I see you've got electric points too, which are handy.
They're very good indeed. We were the pioneer site, I think, in Scotland, electric points, and they now go bombs, particularly with the continental visitors.
When did you found the site?
6 years ago. We've advanced from 200 to 315 now. And we've no doubt about it, we are doing remarkably well, getting a lot of visitors, and many who come back to us year after year.
That's 315 tents and tents, or caravans?
Tents and or caravans.
Tremendous. Christopher, thank you very much indeed.
It costs £1.35 a night to station a car and caravan here, a little less for motor caravans and cars with tents. There's also a limited number of caravans on the site at rents of from £20 a week and cottages from £15 a week. For many motor rail passengers to Perth, the first stop is Pitlochry. It's 25 miles further north in the heart of the Scottish Highlands. The town's an ideal centre from which to tour the mountains, lochs, rivers and woodlands of Tayside.